Our squirrel friend here likes to collect acorns because, really, that's how he is able to live. And let's say every day he collects exactly 3 acorns. And so, what I'm curious about is how many acorns will he have after doing this for 5 days? So, one way to think about it is every day he is able to collect a group of 3 acorns. So, you could view this as maybe what he's able to collect in day one. And then in day two, he's able to collect a second group of 3 acorns. In day three, he's able to collect another group of 3 acorns. And every day, it's an equal number of acorns that he's collecting. On the fourth day, another 3. On the fifth day, another 3. And so, if you were curious how many total acorns he's collected, well, you could just count them up. Or you could think about, well, he's got 5 groups of 3 acorns, 5 equal groups of 3 acorns. So you could say 5 groups of 3 acorns, 3 acorns. And so the total amount would be five, we could view this as 5 threes. Now, 5 threes, you could view this as 5 threes added together, 3 plus 3 plus 3. Plus 3 plus 3. And if you wanted to calculate this, you could skip count by 3. So this would be 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. Because we add 3, we get to 6, we add another 3, we get to 9, we add another 3, we get to 12, we add another 3, we get to 15. And so this would be a way of recognizing that you have 15 acorns. But we're starting to touch on one of the most fundamental ideas in all of mathematics. In fact, we actually are applying it, we just haven't used the word. And that's we are multiplying. We are using multiplication. All multiplication is this notion of multiple equal groups of something. So here, one way to express what we just did is when we said 5 threes, that's the same thing as 5, and I'm going to introduce a new symbol to you, 5 times 3. So all of these things are equivalent. You're already used to seeing equal groups and multiple equal groups, and you're used to adding something multiple times, and you're used to skip counting, and all of that is, in some way, shape, or form, you have been doing multiplication. So when someone says 5 times 3, you could view that as 5 groups of 3, or you could view that as 5 threes, or you could view that as 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3, or you could view that as 15. I'll leave you there. There's a lot of practice on Khan Academy to work through this and make sure you get the underlying idea. But as you'll see, this is perhaps one of the most useful concepts that you might learn in your entire lives.